If you feel old because you've waited so much after your R or Python code to execute, well, this video might be of interest for you because there is actually a solution, and this solution is Julia. Julia is a programming language such as C, Fortran, Java, Python, or R, and I'll tell you why you should at least consider learning this language for your next project. So I'm on the official webpage right now, and I made it quite easy, I have to say, and straightforward to see why. First, it's really fast. Its performance is close to compiled languages such as C, and it can even be better, in my opinion, because it's much more convenient to run your code in parallel, either on the CPU or even on the GPU. And Julia is in the very close group of high-level programming languages to reach petaflops computations, all the other being compiled languages C, C++, and Fortran. And we can see how fast the language is by looking at some benchmarks they provide on their website for different algorithms. And they show that Julia is on par with C for performance and even sometimes faster. And it's not the only fast language they provide on the benchmark. We have Lua, JIT, Rust, Go, and sometimes Fortran that gives similar performances. But what is really interesting in this plot is seeing how fast Julia is compared to similar languages such as Python, R, or MATLAB. Why? Because Julia code is actually compiled using LLVM, but it is still dynamically typed like R or Python. And this makes your programs very fast to prototype and also very fast to execute, meaning you get from the idea to production in no time, because when you're happy with your code, that's it, you're production ready. Then, it's also a great tool to ensure reproducibility of your project. When you set up a project in Julia, it automatically tracks the version of Julia, the version of the packages you're using, and the versions of their dependencies into files. And that means if you write a project now, say you did some data exploration, for example, if you come back 1 year or 10 years later, you'll be able to set up the project exactly as it was the day you set it up, just with one command. And Julia is also composable, meaning it lets you compose with the code of others. And I know other languages do it too, but it's mind-blowing how easy it is using Julia. And all of this comes from the language design itself that lets you develop highly generic algorithms without even knowing it. And all of this magic comes from multiple dispatch. We will explain it in another video, but in the meantime, you can watch this great video from one of the founders of Julia, Stefan Karpinski. You'll find the link in the description if you're interested. The language comes also all batteries included. There are several IDEs, debuggers, profiling, and a great package manager. And it's also interoperable with other languages such as Python, R, MATLAB, C, Fortran, Java, or Scala. Julia is also open source, and it's very easy to access the code, either from GitHub or the command line. And the nice thing is that even base Julia is written mostly in Julia itself, and that makes it very easy to understand if you already learned the language. The Julia language is released under the MIT license, meaning you can do pretty much whatever you want with it. And that's important in my opinion, because if you're working for a company, then you can sell the software you develop and even close source it if you need it. And it's not that simple with R, for example, because it's mostly licensed under GPL2 and GPL3. Another nice thing about this language is that you can install and run the same code base on multiple platforms, such as Windows, Linux, macOS, and also on different architectures, including ARM chips. So I think if you want to be future-proof, it's the right time to start learning Julia. And if you have a little pet project, well, maybe give it a shot. The only case I wouldn't recommend to use Julia yet is for projects where compilation time can be a burden. For example, when you have to open and close Julia many times, because, well, then you'll face latency coming from compilation time. And there are solutions to that, but I feel at the moment, at least, they are more focused towards advanced users. If you're hooked, stay tuned, because this video is part of a playlist with many other videos talking about how to use Julia for your projects. And the next video, for example, will be about how to set up Julia with Visual Studio Code. And the coming other videos will talk about data science in general and algorithm development. Thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. I'll see you next time.